The aim of the self-promotion and packaging 2 module is to add to the work created on the previous one by exploring the theme of containment. My final designs will be containers of myself, my design practice and my personality. This ties perfectly with the idea of creating elements that follow my brand style so that everything is a nice package to present my skills as a graphic designer. After analyzing myself and how I wish to be perceived, I have created a plan for this self-promotion module. On this first part, my goal is to focus on analog tools and analog-inspired design pieces, since the second module concentrates on technology and robots. For the first assignment, I have to choose a day in my life focused on my passion for design to create icons for each of the daily events. Since I work from home, this is a great exercise to rethink my daily schedule. After that, I have revisited my work on concept boards to create 2 different versions. The first one focuses on my design process and includes icons and photographs in the style of a brand mood board. The second one is a portfolio page that could be shared on social media or sent to a client to see a highlight of my best work. The color teal connects both of them with my branding. The next assignment is about sound and design. Firstly, I have talked about the importance of sound and music in podcasts, which are becoming increasingly popular. After describing Armin Hoffman's book With a Sound, I have chosen 3 music samples that I feel describe me personally and professionally. An indie/dream pop song that sparks my creativity. A positive one that brings back good memories. And a motivational song that inspires me. With this in mind, I have done a brainstorm about me and what I like, to create 3 different logos for myself. They each fit one of the songs previously selected. For the third assignment, I have started by creating my own blog in the open source publishing platform Ghost. I have added an About Me page to talk about who I am right now. Then, I have planned and recorded a video about myself and my design process. The process I follow is not universal, but it definitely helps me to have a clear set of steps to follow along the way. The fourth assignment starts diving deeper into the term of containment, and I have researched 3 different designers and artists that use the term as a theme on their work. Inspired by the last artist I researched, José Naranja, I have chosen pages on books as my theme for the assignment number 5. After some brainstorm on this and other themes, I have chosen to work on a project that I call Design Field Guides. The idea is to create A6 field notes notebooks that have a few pages of information at the beginning and blank pages at the end. This is a great leave behind for clients, so they can learn briefly about the different topics, and it also helps me promote myself, my practice and my knowledge. The first one is about the design process and includes the steps I follow as well as some of the tools I use. Finally, I have looked at all the ephemera hanging around my place, including transport tickets, maps, brochures, magazines and labels, and decided to display some of them on a notebook about my most recent trips, Andorra, Berlin and Wales. As a way to combine this work on ephemera with the previous task on containers, I have used a scrap of papers and magazines to create my own junk journal in the style of a scrapbook. The whole module works well as a container of my personality and my passion for notebooks and paper in general, and it packages nicely with the design field guides and the junk journal.